The primary ways that people buy Azure is through either their enterprise agreement, which is also known as the EA, or they buy on the cloud solution provider agreement, also known as the CSP. The EA is an existing agreement that somebody will have in place, and then they can add it on, or they buy it when they buy new. Alternatively, the CSP is much more of a flexible agreement with no commitment levels, and you can buy as and when you want. The things that people wouldn't know with regards to an enterprise agreement are that you have to have a 500 user commitment up front, and those are on products that aren't necessary Azure. With the CSP, you don't have that level of commitment. You buy what you need when you need it. The CSP, in addition, gives you an ability to have a relationship with a reseller that you've not had before. The reseller themselves provides provisioning, they provide the support, they provide pricing, they do the auto billing, and Microsoft is really there to provide the infrastructure, the services. They rely on the CSP program to be able to provide that layer of additional support to their customers. When deciding between an EA and a CSP, the thing that I think people need to think about is the support levels that they're going to get from their partner. The price is always going to be very, very similar, but the support package, you know, the provisioning, the additional services to provide agility, to provide cost optimization, those are the things that people need to think about.